Now, questions are swirling about federal Green Party leader Annamie Paul. She faces a non-confidence vote on Tuesday, and now sources tell CBC News that Paul's own membership may be in jeopardy. We go now to Janice McGregor. So, Janice, what's going on during these closed-door party meetings?
Yeah, there's been a lot of movement here, and I think it's very hard for the average person to understand how things could go like this for this party, which had a fair bit of momentum. You know, you think about how hopeful people were of being able to not just hold the gains they made in the last election, but build on them with this new leader who, at least early in her tenure, seemed to be impressing a lot of people with her energy, her communication skills, her fresh approach. But it has all come crumbling down here. This latest push to review her very membership in the party and possibly revoke it, some seeing that now as a backdoor strategy, perhaps, to force her to step down this summer. Just to remind people kind of how we got here, we were already facing this very extraordinary non-confidence vote at federal council next Tuesday. Remind people how that happened. It stemmed from a dispute within the party over comments made by her senior advisor. She was told by the federal council that she needed to repudiate his remarks. He had challenged sitting MPs. This was all to do with arguments in the party about its Middle East policy, whether the leader was representing it properly, whether the advisor had overstepped, feelings with the MPs that they weren't being allowed to express themselves and represent party policy and the membership. So it's come to this non-confidence vote. And now on top of that, because the leader is being defiant, determined to fight this one out, not bending or you know, giving in to this criticism at all, they're now suggesting this membership review. The emergency meeting first reported by the Toronto Star for Tuesday night, but confirmed by sources to our colleague David Thurton, suggests that she is now facing trouble on a variety of procedural fronts here. Leadership challenge is very much a part of politics, I know, but this is really on a level that I have never seen before. She has not said anything this week. As leader, she is a member of this council, but she wasn't at the emergency meeting on Tuesday night. The Journal de Montréal has reported that she has had her lawyer send a cease and desist letter to a member of this federal council alleging defamation. The federal council itself, remember, the membership has been very fluid. There have been some people resign over this affair. Also, they were in the process of picking new people to sit on that. This has not been a transparent process. It has all been happening behind closed doors, making it very difficult for people to really understand it. A former member of the federal council talked to our colleagues on PEI this week, and she said, look, you know, this is mind-boggling to her as a former party insider. She thinks Annamie Paul is being held to a completely different standard than previous leaders. You know, if she, as a former party insider, you know, looks at this and feels this way, how does that look to the rank and file? How does that look to voters who were potentially considering voting green because, you know, climate change is an important issue to them in a hypothetical election in a few weeks? You know, it is mind-boggling. I think that's a fair word for that former councillor to use.
These just absolutely extraordinary developments that you've been reporting on, they also couldn't come at a more inopportune time. As you were referencing, there could be an election on the horizon. That's the speculation that's swirling. So what could that mean for the Green Party and their campaign?
Well, while your leader is fighting for her job, I'll tell you what she's not doing. She's not out talking to voters about your policy. She is not out fundraising. We are told that this party is burning through its available cash, that it is not looking good at exactly the time when you do want to be flush with cash so you can mount a meaningful campaign. In terms of her own riding, of course, always very important for the leader to have a seat in the House of Commons if it's all possible. But apparently last month, this federal council pulled funds back that had been earmarked for her campaign in a downtown Toronto riding. And on top of all of that, you know, if this non-confidence vote passes at council next week, it will head to the party's annual general meeting in August, August 21st, in fact. That timing could not possibly be worse because, you know, the current kind of read of the election speculation, I'll tell you, would have us into the campaign by then. Just imagine, you're voting to get rid of your leader while a campaign is going on around you.
A lot to continue to watch. Thank you for this, Janice. That's Janice McGregor in Ottawa.